Michael, I'm very honored you can attend the fourth, you know, Canadian International Art Festival. Yep. So yeah, just want like to know what's your impression about this theme festival and what do you want to see most?
Okay. What I want to say most is it's a silent language, like I mentioned earlier, and it's a universal language, visual art. And beauty is the strength of visual art because it's creative and inspires us to come together and be more productive and loving and connected. So this exhibition, this collection of art and collection of people have the same vision of coming together to share, not to compete. It's not about competition. It's about sharing what you consider to be beautiful and what you love, so we can better understand each other and work better together as people and have a richer life. So when I'm inspired to paint, it's always about beauty. But sometimes you can have something like a tornado that's very, very dramatic, and there's an aspect of beauty. But it doesn't seem beautiful if it hits your house. So there's a funny connection with creation and destruction. You could say the mountain wears down and we have grains of sand eventually, and we say we're on a beautiful beach, but it's a mountain that's been deconstructed, and these particles of sand then become something else, maybe even concrete or something, or particles of clay for ceramic. Things are constantly changing. I'd like to maybe refer to maybe one or two paintings on the wall here.
Yep.
And the upper left there, yep, with that big orb, yep, which is essentially the sun, I tried to put the energy into it, but it's uncertain whether the city is actually being energized to increase, or is there so much energy coming from a sun that's changing in cycles, maybe even gamma rays, yep, and weather changes, that it could be something that actually is not life-giving but threatens life. But I'm not about gloom and doom. I'm about we need to watch and be considerate of nature, ourselves, our own health, interrelations, cultures, and so on. It needs nurturing, and we need to pay attention. And as a visual artist, I pay attention by primarily looking. I can see things, you know, and then it enters my feelings, and then I start developing thoughts and word communications as well. I like to write as well. If we look at the central, not quite central, but the one next to it, right, there are four figures there, and in that case, it was something that I saw more like in a dream state, and it's the feminine goddesses, the divine meaning the highest aspects of being a human being, in this case a woman. And I tried to show it an elemental, like water, blue, air, and then more fleshy in the middle, but there's some plants growing around it, and then more fiery, and then more the glow and the internal spiral in the belly.
Thank you for your introduction. Yeah, so I know you are actually the new generation for the group of the seven, right? So yeah, all your picture, all your paintings can show this. Yeah, this is the characteristic.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
About that.
That's right. The lower right painting there is Algonquin Park.
Yeah.
And I dedicated it to Tom Thompson, ode, sunset ode to Tom Thompson.
Wow.
I greatly admired that, inspired the rest of the group. He was the beginning of the group. He didn't become a member because they named themselves after he passed away. And so that's why that one's more naturalistic, because I'm looking back at earlier Canadian heritage as compared to the painting right behind this gentleman here. I call it Stellar Mountain, where you can see stars, yeah, mountain, night.
Yeah.
And I was trying to get the sense that I feel when I look at the night sky that the stars and energy reaches me,
yeah,
and I'm also pulled to it. And there's a relationship between heavenly and earthly. When I mean heavenly, I'm not talking religiously, I'm talking about the night sky, right, and the universe. Northern Lights right there in the middle, that was from a series of an experience I had seeing Northern Lights on Lake Manitou, which is on Manitoulin Island. And it was so beautiful, it was overwhelming. I lay on the ground looking, and it kept coming and coming. Very much what's happening now. But that was from the 90s. So that's what that is about. Now, one of those pictures was shown in China, and to my great surprise, I was told it was selected for a Chinese postage stamp, and two other paintings of mine. And I was told you were the first non-Asian to be on postage stamps. I was so pleased. Not my ego, not my pride, but because there was a connect between China, Chinese people, and me.
That's the feeling. Thank you for your introduction. Okay, nice to meet you. Okay.
Thank you.